I am Zach Shaw. Today is March 12th, 2014. Today is the 1 year anniversary of the funeral that took place after the death of my friend, Mark Deary II. He was born May 28th, 1999, and died March 4th, 2013. He died a month before his 14th birthday. He died way too early, and he did not deserve to go the way he did. He died in the hospital while in a diabetic coma with a blood sugar level of 900. This was very unexpected because Mark was never diagnosed with the disease, and he was never even suspected of having it. He never had any symptoms. Today, I'm going to read you his obituary from the Finger Lakes Times newspaper, and a clipping of his news story from that same paper. Also, I'm going to read a list of names of people who signed a paper to remember Mark Deary. Alright, here is his obituary. His obituary can be found on legacy.com. To find his obituary, search Mark first name, Deary last name, D-E-A-R-Y. And look for the year 2010 to 2014. He will be the only result. Here it is. Clyde. Mark J. Deary II, 13, of 77 Mill Street, Clyde, died unexpectedly from complications of juvenile diabetes on Monday, March 4th, 2013, at the University of Rochester Galisano Children's Hospital. Family and friends are invited to attend his funeral services, which will be held on Tuesday, March 12th at 3 p.m. in the Clyde Community Church, 27 West Genesee Street. Clyde, New York, Reverend Donna Rattray will officiate. Memorial contributions to either the University of Rochester Medical Center, Galisano Children's Hospital, or to a charity of your choice will be appreciated. Mark was born on May 28, 1999 in Newark, New York. The son of Mark J. Deary I and Erica Setzinger. He was the 7th grade student at the Clyde Savannah Junior High School. Mark loved playing video games, watching his favorite shows, The Transformers, or comedian Jeff Dunham on television. He was also an avid Pittsburgh Steelers fan. Surviving are his parents Mark Deary I, Clyde, and Erica Kellum of Clyde, his stepfather Paul Kellum of Clyde, his half-sisters Randy Deary of Rochester, Gianna Deary of Williamson, Claire Kellum of Clyde, and Samantha Kellum of Savannah, his paternal grandmother Joyce Deary of Medina, his maternal grandfather Tom Setzinger of Mendon, his maternal step-grandparents Ronald Wiggins of Clyde and Rose DeVito of Clyde, many aunts, uncles, cousins, and friends. He was predeceased by his paternal grandfather Gerald Deary and his maternal grandmother Linda Wiggins. The family was has entrusted the Barris Funeral Home of Clyde to handle Mark's funeral arrangements. Though short, that obituary did not come close to describing his life. Mark had it hard. He lived with his father, and his mother ignored him due to her new husband and their baby that they had recently had. And he felt that nobody cared about him. He was made fun of at school, constantly bullied or being threatened, and he didn't feel like anywhere was safe for him. Me and Marcus Lazar were his best friends. And 3 days before his death, me and Mark had a serious conversation about diabetes. He, even though he showed no symptoms of the disease, he was worried about it because his father had type 2 diabetes. He asked me, knowing that because my mom had diabetes, I might know a few things about it. And I kind of shrugged it off because he was healthy. I figured there's no way on this earth that this kid could have diabetes. Boy, was I wrong. And I felt extreme guilt on his death, because I felt if I had told him a few of the things, he would have caught it and went to the doctors and been diagnosed and been on medicine for it. I feel guilty right now because I thought today was the anniversary of his death, not his funeral. I had planned this video for a year. But here I am. At least I made it on the anniversary of something revolving him. The anniversary of his funeral. I miss you, buddy. And I will make sure that your name is remembered. Here is a clipping from his news story from Finger Lakes Times newspaper. Juvenile diabetes victim 13 mourned by Jim Miller. Clyde, relatives of 13-year-old Mark J. Deary II hope his death will help raise awareness of diabetes. Deary, who had never been diagnosed with the disease, died Monday at Golisano Children's Hospital in Rochester from complications related to type 1 diabetes. Nobody had a clue, said Deary's aunt, Sue Camp of Lyons. He was physically fine. If you listen to the kids at school, they would tell you. That's all I got. That was the front page clipping. Alright. Now I will read you a list of names of people who signed the paper to remember Mark Deary. I was going to put this on his grave, but seeing how he was cremated, which was his funeral, his burial of choice, I could not. I wanted to also give it to his father so that he knew that how many people cared, but I couldn't face him. I knew how upset he would be of his son's death, and I couldn't face him. I could not remind him of his son's death. Here's the list of people. My name, Zach Shaw. Other people who signed it are Austin Tyler Page Del Papa, Tyler Kendall, Mrs. Becker, Marcus Lazar, Jacob Piso, Sandy Gallo, Coach Dracola, Ruben Oakley, Chelsea Castle, Ryan Breen, Ashlyn Russ, Abby Atherton, Mrs. Haney, Tyler Thorne, Coach Sims, Derek Mann, Hunter Wilbert, Nikki Wright, Russell Brewer, Megan Molisani, Mariah Paddock, Desiree Schult, Jessica West, Amber Goble, Alex Bowen, Ashley Finch, Ryan Jenkins, Caitlin DeSantis, Kiana Lewis, Myra Vandalin, Bailey Farabell, Harley Keis, Michaela Larson, Kirkland Brown, Davina Smith, Mackenzie LaRusso, Jesse Spino, Amber Mills, Missy Durham, Noah Dutcher, Mrs. Bastion, Miss Canali, Noah Tahafogen, and Mrs. Miner. Thank you to all of you who signed this. that makes it so much better for me to know that so many people will remember Mark Deary. I will now leave this, and I will leave his obituary clipping on the screen, along, and I will play his favorite song. Thank you for listening. Bye.